Trimming a video is probably the most frequent task you'll complete when editing. Because unless you film a video in one single take, make no mistakes, and are basically a perfect human just ruling the world, you're gonna need to know how to trim a video to make it shorter or to cut parts out of it. And in my experience making videos for YouTube, not only learning how to trim, but learning how to trim efficiently is super important as a video creator. So in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to easily trim video clips to trim the ends down, cut out parts in the middle, and combine clips using our completely online video editor called Kapwing, and I'll also give you tips for editing efficiently and trimming quickly. Before I jump into it, if you want to receive more video editing tips and learn how to be a modern creator, click that subscribe button, and also check out our Discord. Here's the invite link where you can talk to other video creators and also Team Kapwing members. Now let's get started. So to start trimming a clip online in our video editor Kapwing, you obviously first have to get to Kapwing. So click the first link in the description to get to kapwing.com and you can start a new project. Some of you who are familiar with Kapwing have noticed that the interface for how to trim videos has changed. We did this because it enables more efficiency with trimming and editing clips in general, especially longer videos. I know there is a little bit of a learning curve with it, but hopefully this video will help you get more familiar. And we are always happy to answer any questions you have. So you'll first need to upload your clip. Either click to upload from your files or paste a link to a video from the internet, or you can even just try a sample here. I'm just gonna upload a file I have, and it's starting to upload here, and you'll notice that immediately a box in the bottom of the screen pops up. So this is called the timeline, and this is essentially where all the different pieces that you're adding into your video will appear, from video clips to text layers, image layers. For example, this is this one layer here that you can see is my one video clip. It plays from left to right, and if you play this little play button, it will start playing. You can preview your project in this window here. And this little line is the seeker that allows you to go to any point in the video and see what it would look like. So at the 25 second mark, this is what it looks like on screen. If you ever want more precision in editing in the timeline, editing individual clips here, you can use the zoom in and out buttons here to see a more precise view. As you can see, it's each second becomes longer on the screen and you have to scroll to see the whole project. Similarly, when we zoom out now, we can see more of the project on one screen. And there's a keyboard shortcut that you can use for quicker zooming in and out. If you're using a Mac, you can click Command and scroll, and it zooms in, and then scroll out and it zooms out. And if you're on a Windows, you can use Control plus zooming in. If you ever want to have the whole project on one single screen on the timeline in front of you, you can use this convenient fit to screen button and the whole project will show on one screen. Now, to actually change the timing, the start and end times to trim a clip or any other layer for that matter, this works for text and image layers and audio as well. It's a very similar method to what Kapwing used to look like with the trim window, where essentially you will trim the ends of the clip down by clicking and dragging. So you look at the end of the clips, you'll see that there's a little bar. And if you move over the clip, you'll see that at some point your cursor will turn into a double-headed arrow. That is the indication that you can trim that down. Here it's a regular mouse arrow, and then here's the double-headed arrow. To trim it down, just click and drag the end of the clip to where you want. Anything that you remove will not be in the final video. You can do this at both ends of the clip. Just click and drag when you see that double-headed arrow. If you have more layers in your project, you'll have to first click to select what layer you want to trim, and that's indicated by the white outline on the clip, and then you can make edits to it. With a non-video layer, you'll be able to click and drag the ends to change their start and end time. Now, if you trim down your clip so much that it's hard to find those double-headed arrows, I've trimmed it down to just a second long. What you can do in this case is zoom in more. You can now see the double-headed arrows and then trim to change the start and end times easily. Another way you can make trims is to use the timing tab. So if you click your clip and then go over to here on the right side, there's a tab that says timing. This is where you can specify an exact start and end time instead of clicking and dragging on this space in the timeline here. If you click the numerals, you can use your up and down arrow keys, and it essentially trims it down to start at that time. Same thing with the end. You can use your up and down arrow keys to do either in seconds or milliseconds to do smaller edits. You can also use the seeker to set it at the time you want to end or start the clip, and then click to set to current time using this button here. Now you'll notice that a huge gap is created here when I trimmed down the clip. This is a space, so if you go and see what there is, it's basically a white canvas. It's just a blank canvas until your video starts. If you can leave this empty and add other clips or other things there later, but if you wanna just take that out so that the video starts exactly at zero, just click it and then hit delete on your keyboard and it will move all the clips down. Now, if you trimmed down a clip, you can untrim the clip and extend it back to the original length, but only until the original length because there's no video past that. So I had trimmed down the end of this clip. If I now click it and drag it, adding back the original clip parts that I had previously trimmed. But I can only go so far until it stops. And I can't go past this because that was the end of the original clip. Now, something else that is really helpful and is a staple in video editing is cutting out the middle of a clip. So I just went over how to do the ends by dragging. If you want to cut out the middle of a clip, you can use the split key. So first, drag the seeker to where you want to cut the start of the part that you want to cut out. So for example, if I'm trying to cut out this section starting here and ending at around 17.3 seconds here, there's a couple ways to do it. One method is just to go to that start time, and then you can either use the split button over here, or you can right click and click split here, or you can use the S key on your keyboard. Whichever method you choose, click split, and now you can see that it turns the one original clip into two different clips that you can now click and drag to trim down to the part that you don't want. Or another method is to move the seeker to the end of the part you want to cut out and then do the same thing where you split or use the S key. Now, this is the clip you don't want. You can either move it away into another part of the video by clicking dragging, or you can delete it with your keyboard, or a more efficient way to delete, especially if you're going to be cutting out parts and deleting clips, is to right click the ripple delete option, which basically deletes the clip and also the space that it leaves behind. So if I click that, there we go. So that whole clip and the gap are now removed. I have a smooth clip that doesn't include the part I didn't want. So you can use that method to remove any parts of the video that you don't want from the middle of clips. Another tip I have for efficiently editing, especially if there are a lot of parts in the video you're going to want to cut out, is you can just start playing the video and then use your S key to split the clip at any part that you want to start deleting. Make sure the clip is selected, and then when you start playing, I'm gonna click split whenever I want to remove a part. And this is just makes it easier and faster to hit all of those parts that you don't want, and then you can go in afterwards and then quickly delete them like this. As I said earlier, this works with any layers for trimming and cutting out parts in the middle. I've just added a sample audio track, and it's the same exact process. You can select the track and then click and drag down or out to trim the start and end time, or use the timing tab to select a part of the middle to cut out. You can click it and then click the split button or S key and do the same thing. Make sure to check out all the other options in the top bar here, as well as on the side here for things like output size and background color. And then once you are ready to get your video to download, click the red export video button. Your video will load for a few moments and then your video will be done. And then you can click the download button over here to save it to your local device. So those are the different ways you can trim a video clip in Kapwing. If you have questions still or comments, thoughts, leave them in the comments below. And also let us know if you want to see any other videos on this channel. We'll see you in the next one.